Welcome to This Just In, a weekly news show highlighting the people and events in Newport News Public Schools. During Teacher Appreciation Week, 43 teachers in Newport News Public Schools were honored at the annual Teachers of the Year Awards Banquet. Superintendent Dr. Ashby Kilgore, school board members, administrators, and community leaders recognized the highly qualified educators who were selected to represent their schools during a dinner and presentation of awards at the Newport News Marriott at City Center. After hearing comments from the previous Division-wide Teacher of the Year, math teacher Carrie Enott from Nashville High School, each teacher received some much-deserved recognition for their hard work and consistent dedication to the students of Newport News. With over 99% of Newport News Public Schools teachers designated as highly qualified by federal standards, the selection process for the evening's top honors was no easy task. From the 29 early childhood centers and elementary schools, Jackie Barber, an interventionist at Newsom Park Elementary with 13 years of teaching experience, was selected as the 2016-2017 Elementary Teacher of the Year. Katie Morgan, a professional school counselor from Dozier Middle School with 5 years of experience, received the Middle School Teacher of the Year Award. And Eric Tyson, a military science instructor from Heritage High, with 9 years in the classroom after serving our country in the U.S. Coast Guard, was recognized as the High School Teacher of the Year. From these three prestigious educators, school counselor Katie Morgan received the honor of the 2016-2017 Division-wide Teacher of the Year for Newport News Public Schools. Katie will now represent our school system in the Virginia Teacher of the Year program, as well as numerous events throughout the upcoming school year. Congratulations to all of this year's Teachers of the Year. Students from every high school in Newport News Public Schools took their show on the road to present high-level learning options and unique opportunities to shoppers at Patrick Henry Mall on a Saturday afternoon. The SAGE Expo was organized by the Student Advisory Group on Education, a select group of student representatives from each high school who meet monthly with Superintendent Dr. Ashby Kilgore to offer insights on a variety of educational topics. Each school set up booths with informative displays, student artwork, and engaging activities designed to inform prospective high school students and the community as a whole about the unique offerings at each school. Students and staff interacted with mall shoppers and even gave folks their own chance to experience life in our cutting-edge classrooms. And on the main stage in the food court, each high school put their musical talents on display with a range of impressive performances. Through the SAGE Expo, our students were able to tell their own story of how they're becoming college, career, and citizen ready at their high schools in Newport News Public Schools. Carver Elementary students learned why they have many reasons to be proud of their school's name.
George Washington Carver has been called the plant doctor and the peanut man. So when a school is named after this famous botanist, chemist, inventor, and educator, students have good reason to learn from his lasting legacy. That's just what second grade teacher Julie Weaver decided when she helped organize Carver Elementary's first annual George Washington Carver Week. In every classroom, students learned about the life and contributions of George Washington Carver. Through writing prompts and art activities, they learned how he researched and invented over 300 uses for peanuts. And just like Carver, students invented a variety of tools and machines during engaging STEM activities. While outdoors, students shared Carver's love for plants by planting their own flower garden in the school's courtyard. Students expanded on Carver's affection for nature by using homemade plant-based paints to decorate rocks. This type of interactive learning helps students connect with Carver and hopefully inspire a new generation to strive for their own greatness. The week wrapped up with an energetic pep rally, emceed by WTKR Channel 3 news anchor Jessica Larchet, and powerful music by Crittenden Middle School's pep band. The ladies from the Newport News chapter of The Links Incorporated, a nonprofit community service organization, sponsored the event. They also helped bring in renowned art evangelist and educator, Steve Prince. Over the weekend, Prince worked closely with students who participate in the 21st Century Enrichment activities at Carver and Heritage High. With assistance from local artist Dathan Kane, who was a student of Prince's years ago at Hampton High, Prince helped the students design an inspiring mural that reflected the life and accomplishments of George Washington Carver. The result of the first annual George Washington Carver Week is a school full of young learners who are now connected through educational experiences to an historical icon of great importance and character.
Since Deer Park Elementary is the environmental science magnet program in Newport News Public Schools, celebrating Earth Day was a whirlwind of fun and educational activities. For 2 days, every student was engaged in and outside of the school, learning how to care for our planet. Teachers designed grade appropriate and interactive activities, with many of these supporting classroom instruction by tying in math, science, and English skills. Grade levels offered a series of activities that allowed their classes to take turns rotating through learning stations, with parent volunteers assisting the teachers and students. And many students purchased a Star Wars themed shirt to help celebrate Earth Day at Deer Park. Kindergartners focused on the theme of water and learned how pollution in our waterways affects wildlife and humans. First graders used their artistic talents to decorate rocks that will be placed around the butterfly garden in the courtyard. They also teamed up to design and paint their grade's bench that was constructed by the school's PTA volunteers. Second graders took turns gardening, weeding, and working in the school's courtyard to prepare the outdoor classroom and raised garden beds for spring weather. Lab instructional assistant and resident vermicomposting expert Julie Ward helped third grade students start a worm composting bin with a batch of red wigglers. Third graders also spent time outdoors inspecting and documenting all that nature provides in a square foot of earth. The fourth grade spent time upcycling plastic orange juice containers as pots for brand new flowers. And fifth graders repurposed plastic water bottles as rain gauges to measure precipitation during the rainy spring months. All of these activities, plus many more, helped Deer Park students make the connection between using what they're learning in school and the lifelong skills they'll use to benefit the earth every day of the year. Newport News fifth graders recently enjoyed the cultural experience of the Virginia Symphony Orchestra, which performs a young people's concert series as part of its educational program. Fortunately for our students, the Ferguson Center for the Arts, located on Christopher Newport University's campus here in Newport News, was one of the venues. First and foremost, the goals of this special concert were to introduce the students to symphonic music and to have them learn about the various instruments that make up an orchestra. But the event also incorporated connections to the Virginia State Standards of Learning. The concert presented a world of music, sounds of the continents. This symphonic experience was tailored to the students' grade level while taking them on a musical trip around the world and visiting the rhythms, melodies, and harmonies of every continent. The resident conductor for the symphony, Benjamin Rouse, took time before each musical selection to discuss several instruments and to introduce the composers as well as the creative and geographic backgrounds of the music. Through this experience, the students gained an appreciation for the beautiful music created through a variety of instruments and across all continents. Thanks for joining us for this week's edition of This Just In. And check out more fun and informative videos at nnpstv.com to see the many great things happening in Newport News Public Schools. Thanks for watching.